Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In this video, we will practice multi-value parameters in Power BI. In Power BI, we have multiple options to configure parameter, such as we can configure parameter as with accepting list of values, query, and others. But here in this video, we will discuss a very specific requirement where we should be able to accept multiple values and the data must be filtered on given values. So let's understand the requirement in Power BI Desktop. So here in Power BI Desktop, we can see we have sales data, and here we can see in column region, we have regions like Central, East and West. And now let's say if there is a requirement that the data must be filtered based on multiple regions such as Central and East only. So for that, there could be a multiple ways to configure this in Power BI. So let's say by applying filter on column itself, like if I want to select Central and East only, then I can apply filter over here. And this would be the easiest way. But let's say if there is a requirement that we are not sure what values will be available over here in production environment. Since we are not sure about those values and the value will be configured by the DevOps team while publishing report in the production environment. In such case where we want to keep this filter nature dynamic, then we need to accept values in parameters. So for that, let's go to the query and first understand the data. So here in a query, we can see we have sales data. And now I have a parameter called regions, and in regions we can see I have given East, Central and West as a parameter. Now let me remove this West from here, and now let's go back to query and refresh the data. And here we can see we are getting data only for East and Central, and West is no more available in this data. Now let's go back to the parameter once again, and this time let's add East and West. And let's refresh the data once again. And here we can see now we are getting data for East and West. And now let's assume in future there is a new region has been added that is not part of the existing data. Let's say the value is East Asia. So in this way our query is still working. And as soon as we will get data for East Asia region, the data filter will work accordingly. So now let's try to understand how this solution works. So here in SQL Server, we can see we have sales data grocery table where we have sales data for all the regions. Now as per the requirement, if we want to filter the data based on multiple regions, then I have to add where condition where region in, and then I have to provide the values. So let's say I want to add East and West. And now let's execute the query. And here you can see we are getting data for East and West. That means we need to add this where condition in Power BI mQuery. So for that, we can write a query in a way that we should be able to split this input parameter that is East and West entered by user and populate this where condition in SQL Server. So for that, here there is another query where we can do that. So here in this query, we can see using the cross apply string split function, the query is able to split this string as a table that we can use in an in operator. And here instead of region in this hard code value, we can add the subquery. And let's execute this query. And here we can see we are getting East, Central and West. Now let me remove East from this subquery. And let's filter data only for West and Central. And here we can see we are getting West and Central only. Now let me remove West as well. And let's execute this. And now we are getting Central region data only. So now let's add this subquery in Power BI in mQuery section. So for that, here in Power BI Query Editor, we have parameter called regions and its parameter type is text. And under that, we can accept multiple values separated by comma from the user. And now let's go back to the query one again. And here we want to modify the query. So for that, let's go to the advanced query editor. And here we can see we have query that is select star from sales data grocery. And thereafter, we have to add the same condition what we have in SQL Server Management Studio, that is where region in, and the remaining query. And this part that is comma delimited regions, that we have accepted from the parameter. So we can add the parameter name over here, and that's it. And our query should work. So let me remove this Asia and West, and let's keep East only. And let's refresh the data. And here we are getting only East region data. So with this approach, we can see we are able to accept multiple values as input in the parameter. And same values we can use in a query as a filter using the mQuery in the advanced query editor. And also this approach is user friendly and dynamic, as we don't need to have the data available in the database. We can accept the data values dynamically from the user, and it can accept new values as well. And this approach is efficient in performance because the filter has been applied on the source data itself. So the query performance would be fast. And this approach will work with import as well as direct query both. Let me know if you find any other approach that you feel is a better solution for this requirement.